Hi everyone, this is Dr. Chris from Operation Ouch, and I wanted
to... And Dr. Xand!
They can see you're sitting right there.
Yeah, but I still like to say hello.
Welcome hello. To...
One of our favourite bits of the show!
Can I hit play?
Yeah.
Can I hit play?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna hit play now.
On Operation Ouch, we've been hitting the hospital wards to show you what goes on. Today, Chris is on duty in the Allergy Clinic.
Prawns, cheese and nuts. What do these three things have in common?
No one's ever eaten cheese and prawns. That's not a thing you eat, ever.
Well, you're never given the chance.
You're disgusting. But foods like this are also the main cause of a problem that some of you may have. I'm talking about food allergy.
An allergy can cause the body to react in extreme ways.
Nasty contact dermatitis there.
Dermatitis, derm is skin, itis is inflammation. And inflammation, it's a bit like your skin's on fire. It means it's got hot and red and tender and it's often itchy.
This is consultant Dr. VIBHA Sharma, a specialist in allergies. She'll tell us everything we need to know.
So Dr. Sharma, what is an allergy?
This is like a hard-hitting interview, Chris. Dr. Sharma, what is an allergy?
Allergic reaction is when somebody's been given something that they do not agree with and their body reacts to it.
What happens when someone gets an allergic reaction?
Come on, Dr. Sharma, answer the question!
Dr. Sharma was quite busy and she had gone at that point. And sometimes you just do it, a little thing of me asking the questions. She's already given the answer and then you just... I'm just talking to an empty space. So tell me, Dr. Sharma, what is an allergy?
I have to go to a meeting.
This is Haroon, who has a suspected milk allergy.
When I have something with milk in it, I get a bit itchy on my body.
And this is Holly, who has a suspected nut allergy.
So the last time I had peanuts was when I was 18 months old and I had an extremely big reaction to that.
So Holly's just not eating any nuts since she was 18 months old.
They've both come into the clinic today for allergy testing.
We do this test that's called a challenge test.
The allergy challenge test means that Haroon and Holly will be taking small bites of foods Dr. Sharma thinks they're allergic to.
So Haroon and Holly must both now be grown-ups.
Yeah, I haven't thought of that.
Wonder what they're up to. Holly, Haroon, if you're watching, send us a message on Twitter or Instagram and we'll say hi.
They'll both be monitored closely by the medical team just in case they start to have an allergic reaction.
Once you're on a monitor, you feel a bit safe. Do you know what I mean? They put you on a monitor and you're like, now the machine is looking after me.
Holly's trying chocolate with nuts in it. She hasn't eaten nuts for 11 years, so how's it going down?
I've just had my first bit and so far, so good.
Haroon's had one bite of pasta with milk in the sauce. How's he doing?
It feels like I'm getting a bit itchy.
Haroon's itchy skin could be the sign of an allergy, but nothing major is showing yet. Time for a second bite. Anything happening?
Second one now and I'm still all right.
In fact, after a few more bites of her dreaded food, it's good news for Holly.
I mean, that is quite a good medical test where you just have to eat chocolate.
They confirmed for me that I'm not allergic to any nuts at all.
So it's thumbs up for Holly. As you grow older, it's possible for the body to build up a tolerance to some allergies. So, one down, one to go. How's Haroon getting on? He's trying another spoonful, and now an even bigger spoonful. The doctors are building him up to a full meal to see his reaction. He started itching a lot.
Oh, poor old Haroon.
And this is definitely an allergic reaction. When this happens, your body releases chemicals called histamines, and this is what makes you...
We have the best animations on Operation Ouch. If at medical school we'd had the animations that we have on Operation Ouch, I would have found it easier to learn everything.
The histamines released not only make Haroon itchy, but also cause little bumps on his skin called hives.
Do you know why they're called hives?
No.
It's an old Scottish word meaning heave, with the idea that these bumps heave out of your skin. They sort of erupt out of your skin. It's mad, but it goes back to the 16th century. There you go. Often I know more than Dr. Chris about something.
I'm allergic to the milk in the pasta.
The allergy challenge has confirmed Haroon's body is still sensitive to milk. He'll need to avoid eating anything with milk in it to make sure he doesn't have a nasty reaction in the future.
We once got attacked by bees and Xand swelled up and I didn't. This reminds me of the time that Max came in with his swollen lip.
His lip blew up? What happened? Let's have a look at Max.
A few minutes ago, I realised that my lip was all swollen.
Did he say he had a swollen lip?
Yes, look. Poor Max.
And kind of really showing his lip off there.
When it touches my teeth, it hurts.
It hurts when it touches his teeth, so it's very sensitive. When your lip's swollen like that, it really hurts.
Max was having a normal day. He'd been to school, like normal. And then afterwards, he'd been swimming.
I love these animations. They're so good. It's quite exciting. The first time I saw myself animated, I was quite pleased with it all.
It's lovely, isn't it? At some level, like, I've always dreamed of being a cartoon character. Like, that's a dream that everyone has, I think.
That's how everyone thinks of you.
It really stung when it started going really big.
Poor old Max, his lip's stinging because the skin is being stretched, and so it really hurts. It's as if almost someone has injected fluid under it and it's stretching the skin.
So Max doesn't think he's eaten nuts or white fish, which he's allergic to. But with symptoms like this, he's taking a medicine called antihistamine, just in case it is an allergic reaction.
Well, here's someone who can bust that lumpy lip. It's Dr. Sara Syed.
So was it sore? Was it tingly?
Stinging.
It was stinging, was it?
Yeah.
OK. Did you feel like your throat was getting tight or anything?
No.
No.
Dr. Sara needs to give Max a thorough examination.
Give it a good squeeze there.
Whether or not he's having an allergic reaction.
Oh, can you just sit after me?
If he is, the biggest concern is that it could get.
And it's a big deal. Tongue swelling and throat swelling is potentially really dangerous. So that's what she's checking carefully for.
Is that sore at all?
No.
Okay, so there's no swelling at the back of your throat, which is really good.
Luckily, Max's throat and airways are clear. But what about his lip? Is it from an allergy?
It looks like some form of allergic reaction, OK? Just with there being the swelling and this tingling, it kind of all fits in with that picture.
The good news is that the antihistamine has started to work.
You've got a tingly swelling, and it's going down. So histamine is in cells in your body, and it gets released at all sorts of different situations, and it is the itchy chemical, makes you itch.
How are you feeling?
Better.
Yeah?
High five, antihistamine.
What exactly has made him have that allergic reaction is a little bit of a mystery. It seems like his immune system just responded quite strongly to something.
Yeah, quite often in the hospital you don't know what's going on, do you? It's like you've got to be a bit of a detective, but also sometimes you just don't get the answer.
It might be that Max has developed a new allergy.
To try and find out, he'll return for an allergy test in a week's time.
Take care.
We'll be back later to find out how he gets on.
We can't leave Max's story there, Chris. I want to know what happens. Ouch.
Time to see how Max is getting on.
Let's head back to accident and emergency.
Oh, that's not a very good link.
Wow. That was really weird and boring, wasn't it? Here we go. Let's watch this.
It's funny. If you watch the old series, what you see is that we're nervous and we don't quite know what we're doing.
It's not quite like that. So those little what we call links, where Xand and I go, coming up today on Operation Ouch or whatever, are called they're links because they link one bit of a program to another. And we film them all together over an entire day. The reason we do those links days is because Xand and I aren't in A&E.
You know, the reason that we can't be in A&E is because we don't know when people are going to get ill. If we could organise the accidents and the illnesses, then we could film it all according to our schedule. Like, if you put a bucket of paint above a door, and then when you opened it, it fell on your head, and then we could film that. You know what I mean? I'm trying to think, we're not allowed to do that.
Xand and I have other jobs, so we can't hang around in the emergency department waiting for the perfect storm.
We're not allowed to organise accidents up and down the UK so that then we can film them in A&E and do it to our schedule. We're just not allowed. It's not allowed, Chris. Not allowed. We're not going to do it.
Let's keep watching the video.
Max is allergic to peanuts and white fish, but he hadn't eaten either of those things that day. However, Max has a theory.
Uh-oh, Mum's in trouble.
Mummy said she was eating nuts, and she touched me on my face.
I might have to hold my hands up to that because I do eat nuts at home, but we do keep them out of his way.
So it turns out Max's mum was eating nuts.
she's been brave and honest and said. A lot of people would go, I think I won't mention that. Whereas she's sort of gone, look, I think this is what's going on, which is good. Good. Well done, Max's mum, I say.
Well, it could be his mum, but it could also be something new.
I like that these are called hero shots, because no one wants to stand still and just be filmed like, and they always find it really awkward. And we say we'll put like graphics, we'll change the colour, you're going to look really cool and we'll move you around, but no one ever believes us, they don't like it.
E specialist nurse Sarah Allard, and gosh, she's a terrible speller. No, Xand, she's putting a variety of allergy samples onto Max's arm to see which ones get a reaction. And it's not just food types.
This is dog.
She's also testing for things in the environment, including dogs.
Look at that, a little bottle of dog. What do they put in the bottle? Do they go and just scrape a dog into the bottle? Like, whose dog is it? And what about, like, a rabbit? Like, a dog or a cat, I suppose you could just go out on the street and find one. But a rabbit, you know, you can't go into a field.
Running around the field.
Well, no, but no one's doing that realistically.
Just get someone's pet rabbit. Loads of people have rabbits. Loads of people have rabbits. That's, like, one of the easiest things. You go to any petting zoo and be like, can we borrow your rabbit for 2 minutes? And then just shake it over the...
How do they do it? Do they dip the rabbit
in? I don't know. If we listened, we might learn.
I don't think it explains it.
So our tests today said, yes, you're still allergic to whitefish and peanut. But what we've also learnt today is that you are allergic to cats.
So was Max playing with cats on the day his lips swelled up? No.
And you are allergic to grass.
Ooh, was he rolling around like I do when I'm allowed?
No, Xand, he wasn't.
So we're still none the wiser about why his lip grew so big.
Well, Max still has his theory.
Don't blame your mum on the telly!
I think it was mum.
Your mum?
Well, mum looks cross.
Don't, if you're being filmed, just go, I love my mum.
Bye.
In that amazing A&E story, we've learned that the allergies are caused by histamines, how to treat them using antihistamines, how to test for allergies. We've learned all about Max's allergies, and we've learned that if you live with someone with a peanut allergy, you should
don't
not
eat peanuts and give them a kiss.
Eat peanuts and give them a kiss.
Like, it is really important. You've got to be really careful. We've also learned that Chris and I have got better at links. Coming up next on Operation Ouch. You don't know, do you? You don't know what the next bit is.
Always,
he doesn't know. He doesn't
know.
He hasn't got better at links. 10 years later and he's still, just goldfishing away.
Coming up next on Operation Ouch
nothing.
Is nothing.
It's
the end.
It's the end, that's it.
Bye!
Bye! Operation Ouch.